Welcome. In the previous video, I covered everything you needed to know from Season 7 of Unalive. Today, it's time to do the same with Season 8, which is the final season in the series. So, this 8th and final season is slightly longer than the others, featuring 15 episodes instead of the usual 10, and puts an end to the second storyline of the show. Season 8 is a direct continuation from the end of Season 7. This means that it takes place in the summer of 2030, in around July and August, which is just some minutes after the end of the previous season. This season will be slightly different, as instead of just learning about the past of the protagonists and different characters through reoccurring flashbacks, we will also learn about their future through flash-forwards. Each flash-forward will give minimal information about the surrounding characters that the episode isn't centered on, so the audience isn't fully aware of who will make it through till the end. So, our protagonists were left stranded in the middle of the road in the ending of the previous season, after Jack was finally taken away from them by the moths, who believe they can develop a vaccine and end the apocalypse with the young boy since he is immune to the fungus. In this season, our protagonists will work together to get Jack back and take down the moths in the process. In this season, we will also be introduced to three new key characters. Jerry McKinney, Elena Page, who are both members of Lake Rocks, a small community of people trying to survive throughout the apocalypse, and Rizni. Additionally, we will also see the return of Kenny Elliott, who decided to embark on his own journey after the end of Season 5. Now, without further ado, it's time to begin with the episode guide. Episode 1, Lake Rocks, is centered around Peter. Main plot: Nick stares in anger as the moths have left with Jack. Liz comforts Isla, who's crying uncontrollably. Nick confirms to the group he will bring Jack back even if it means dying in the process. Later, Peter tries to fix the blown-out wheels so that they can get going. But after failing to fix them, a car stops and out walks a man who reveals himself to be Jerry. He looks sincere and kind and offers to help get the RVs fixed. The protagonists oblige. After fixing it, he offers them to visit his camp, Lake Rocks, and they accept, not having a better option. There, they meet the leader, Elena, who welcomes them to stay for a while and offers them a large dinner as they are all starving. However, at midnight after the dinner, Nick sneaks out on his own in search of Jack. Peter, the only one who saw him, tells him to wait until morning so more people can join him, but Nick can't wait. Meanwhile, Dr. Reed introduces himself to Jack and they perform an X-ray on him. Cliffhanger. Nick leaves Lake Rocks at midnight without the knowledge of his group to search for Jack. Flash forward plot. Set 1 year into the future, Peter and Savannah are still living in Lake Rocks. With the two finally happy and at peace, the couple decide that now is the perfect moment for a baby. Peter takes care of Savannah during the pregnancy, and once the little baby girl is born, Savannah, whilst in tears of joy, asks to call her Olivia, in memory of her dead sister. Episode 2, Sorrow, is centered around Sophie. Main plot. The next morning, the protagonists notice Nick is missing, and Peter confirms he left last night. In a rush, Lydia, Sophie, Lily, and Danny set out to look for him and help him find Jack. Elena tries convincing them to stay, but fails. Meanwhile, Nick continues his journey and stumbles upon a moth vehicle parked outside an abandoned gas station. He sees Sabika inside alongside other moths. Sometime later, Nick sneaks into the gas station whilst they are distracted. Once he's within reach, he sneakily kills the men and takes Sabika as a hostage and for leverage. Simultaneously, Dr. Reed tries to inject liquids into Jack's limbs, but Jack is scared and resists. Robert is forced to drug him unconscious for Dr. Reed to proceed. Cliffhanger. Jack is injected with the mysterious liquids. Flash forward plot. Set 1 year into the future, Sophie leaves Lake Rocks to search for the graves of her mother and sisters. She lies to Elena and tells her she's only going for a walk. After hiking for a day, killing some Unalive along the way, she finds them and grieves in peace. She places her chain on top of her mother's grave. Episode 3, Hostage, is centered around Danny. Main plot. Nick forces Sabika into the moth car parked outside the gas station and tells her to take him to wherever Jack is. Sabika refuses, but he points a gun at her head and she complies. Sabika starts driving, but soon crashes the car into a tree only some minutes later. She takes the opportunity to get out and run whilst Nick is still trapped in the car. However, Lydia, Sophie, Lily, and Danny have caught up and spot Sabika running away. Danny shoots her in the leg with a rifle and she's forced to stop. Lydia takes Sabika, whilst the rest help Nick, who is still stuck in the car. He thanks them, but they're angry at him for leaving unannounced. Meanwhile, Dr. Reed and Johnson talk about the vaccine. Elena worries for our protagonists. Cliffhanger. Danny repeatedly asks Sabika where Jack is, before she finally tells them that it's too late to save him. Flash forward plot. Set 2 years into the future, Danny is outside butchering a boar when Elena approaches him. The two grow closer. Later, Danny catches Elena crying, and an unexpected romance occurs when the two start making out and making love. Episode 4, Knockdown, is centered around Cynthia. Main plot: with Sabika refusing to cooperate, Danny suggests going back to Lake Rocks. Lily agrees. Nick refuses, claiming there's no point in doing that, and says he will continue searching for Jack. Their conversation is abruptly interrupted by another moth car that starts shooting at them. The protagonists manage to take down the men inside the car and force the only one left, who reveals his name to be Rizni, to surrender. Rizni yells in frustration at Sabika for being caught whilst being tied up by Danny and Nick. After interrogating him, he reveals the path to find Jack, wanting to avoid being tortured. All of them get going. Back in Lake Rocks, Peter, Savannah, Cynthia, Haley, and Sky arm up to search for the ones who left, worried something might have happened. Jerry gives them a map. Cliffhanger. Danny, Sophie, Lydia, Lily, Nick, Sabika, and Rizni stumble upon a large abandoned city, protected by a massive wall and an electric fence. Flash forward plot. Set 1.5 years into the future, Cynthia is still mourning Philip's death. One day, whilst out collecting goods with other Lake Rocks members, Cynthia comes across a boxing punch bag. She takes it and continues practicing in her room. There, Jerry sees her one day and begins to tell her about his boxing experience. He teaches her some tricks and the two become good friends. Episode 5, One Fair City, is centered around Lydia. Main plot: Lydia suggests going off track and going around the electric fence, but Nick reassures her that it'll waste too much time and that it's better to go directly through the city. Danny finds out that the electric fence is coded, and Nick asks Rizni for the pin. Rizni claims he doesn't know it, and Nick threatens to kill him. Rizni complies and slowly enters the pin. Once he's entered the code, he tells them it's safe. However, Nick doesn't trust him and pushes him into the fence to verify whether or not it's safe. The protagonists scream as Rizni is brutally electrocuted and dies. With that idea out of the way, Nick comes up with a strategy. They cut down a tree and place it against the fence to climb it. Meanwhile, the other protagonists, Peter and Co., are catching up to them. Jack wakes up locked in a room confused, and Dr. Reed comes in to tell him how special he is for being immune. Cliffhanger. Johnson tells Dr. Reed that they will have everything ready to complete the surgery on Jack in a matter of days. Flash forward plot. Set 2 years into the future, Lydia has become one of the leaders of Lake Rocks, which reminds her to her past in the army. She navigates the complexities of leadership whilst being haunted by her past. In the end, Elena refers to Lydia as the daughter she never had, making her very proud and happy. Episode 6, The Tombs, is centered around Nick. Main plot: Nick, Lydia, Lily, Danny, Sophie, and their hostage Sabika walk through the abandoned city. They enter a large building. A painting catches Nick's attention, who gets left behind with Sabika whilst the rest of the group continue exploring the building. As Nick tries to catch up with them, him and Sabika fall through the floor into a dark underground tunnel. Danny and the others run back to see if Nick is okay. Lydia suggests jumping to join him, but Nick claims he sees an exit and they can be reunited outside. Nick and Sabika walk through the creepy and dark tunnel covered in hieroglyphs. Sabika asks to be cut loose so they can work together, and Nick accepts. Eventually, they find a room that leads directly outside, however, the room is filled with the Unalife. Sabika suggests going back, but Nick signals her to be quiet and reassures her that it's the only exit. They both stand as still as statues to not alarm the Unalife, since they are blind and depend entirely on their hearing. Very steadily and slowly, they walk across the room, with the Unalife just inches away from them. When they've almost reached the exit, Sabika steps on a squeaky floorboard that alarms the Unalife, who start attacking her. Nick makes a run for the exit and closes the door before he can get bitten. Now outside and safe, he sees Sabika still inside, screaming whilst being eaten alive. He runs away. Later, he spots the other protagonists on higher ground. Cliffhanger. Danny, Sophie, Lydia, and Lily are trying to find Nick, but instead stumble upon Peter, Savannah, Cynthia, Haley, and Sky, who have caught up to them. Flash forward plot. Set 6 months into the future, Nick is back in DC, now on his own. We see Nick holding the teddy bear. Nick returns to the farm and bunker from season 1, both abandoned and empty. After some time, Nick spots an Unalife approaching him. He gets closer and recognizes his ex-wife Maggie. Nick breaks down in tears. The Unalife Maggie tries to attack him and he shoots her in the head. Nick cries. Episode 7, Old Friends, is centered around Savannah. Main plot: Nick continues to search for the protagonists through the abandoned city. After entering an empty police station, a mysterious man points at him with a rifle from behind and demands Nick to drop on his knees. The man approaches him to take away his gun. When Nick turns to face the man, he's shocked as he recognizes Kenny. The two look at each other in disbelief before Nick starts to ask questions. Kenny gives vague answers. Meanwhile, the reunited group of protagonists search across the city for Nick. Savannah finds a car that she believes can be used. Simultaneously, Dr. Reed feeds Jack and makes him feel better. Robert and Francis try to make contact with Sabika but fail, so they try Rizni but fail again. They start suspecting something has happened to them. Cliffhanger. After some studying, Dr. Reed tells Johnson that the surgery will very likely kill Jack. Johnson tells him it doesn't matter. Flash forward plot, set 1.5 years into the future, Peter and Savannah continue living their lives in Lake Rocks, now raising their baby daughter Olivia. Peter is worried he might not be the father he wants to be, but Savannah reassures him. Episode 8, What Kenny Did, is centered around Kenny. Main plot: Kenny and Nick traverse through the city before finally being reunited with the rest of the protagonists. Peter and the others are shocked to see Kenny again and start bombarding him with questions. But Kenny gives no time for an interrogation, suggesting they're in a rush. Danny suggests taking the car Savannah found to get to Jack faster, but Haley points out that there is no space for everyone to fit. Nick convinces the boys, Danny, Kenny, and Peter, to go with him whilst the girls return to Lake Rocks. Lydia and Lily object, but are given no choice. The men leave in the car. Meanwhile, Jack asks Dr. Reed if he will die, making him feel guilty. Robert expresses his concern to Johnson surrounding the disappearance of Sabika. Cliffhanger. Johnson scolds Robert for letting Nick and his friends go in the first place and orders him to kill Nick. Johnson is sure Nick and his friends are searching for Jack. Flashback plot. Set 3 years into the past, up until present day, we learn about how Kenny started working for the Moths. Robert convinced him that they were doing what was best in everyone's interest, which is finding the vaccine. However, Kenny ended up having to kill enemies of the Moths in the name of Johnson, many of them being innocent. Because of this, he grew tired of the Moths. Episode 9, Stranded, is centered around Chloe. Main plot: whilst Nick, Kenny, Danny, and Peter are heading towards the base of the Moths, where they believe Jack is, their car runs out of fuel and they are left stranded. They are forced to go the rest of the way on foot. At the same time, the girls left behind find another car and head the same direction as Nick, ignoring what he told them to do previously. Meanwhile, Chloe is still recovering after her hand was cut off. Elena and Liz take care of Isla, who misses Jack. Simultaneously, Robert, Francis, and other Moths set out to look for Nick and kill him once and for all. Dr. Reed makes one final scan of Jack's organs. Cliffhanger: Savannah, Lydia, Sophie, Cynthia, Haley, Skye, and Lily find the boys' car stranded in the middle of the road. They go to investigate, and Sky is attacked by an Unalife hiding inside. Flash forward plot: this is a continuation of Sophie's story. Set 1 year into the future, Chloe follows Sophie without her knowledge. When Sophie is grieving in peace, Chloe confronts her for lying about where she was heading. After an emotional speech, the two girls kiss and confess their feelings. Episode 10, Pride, is centered around Robert. Main plot: the girls manage to save Skye from the Unalife. Meanwhile, Robert stops at an abandoned gas station on his own whilst the rest of the Moths continue, wanting to take a small break. Nick, Danny, Peter, and Kenny are nearby. Nick runs off and leaves the boys behind after hearing something only he perceived. They wonder what to do before running to search for him. Nick ends up stumbling upon Robert at the gas station. Robert is surprised but delighted by the occasion. They knock off each other's guns and go fist to fist. Robert easily overpowers Nick and has him beat down. Nick is struggling to react. Robert soon has him on the floor. However, when Robert turns around to pick up his gun, Nick makes him trip and steals it himself, pointing it at his head. By that point, Danny, Kenny, and Peter have caught up to him and advise him not to kill Robert. Nick demands to know where Jack is, but Robert doesn't comply. Nick insists, but Robert refuses to cooperate and Nick shoots him in the head. Meanwhile, Jack cries in frustration, worried he might die. Cliffhanger. Nick, unsure of where to go after Robert refused to help, splits up the group of boys. He and Kenny will travel west while Peter and Danny head east. They all say goodbye to each other. Flashback plot. Set all the way back to the first day of the apocalypse, we learn about Robert's past working for the government and how he became one of the first Moth members after the group was first formed. Robert worked his way to the top until Counselor Johnson awarded him the captain role. We also learn about the initial objectives of the Moths and how they quickly became a corrupt organization. Episode 11, Not Dead Yet, is centered around Jack. Main plot: Dr. Reed and the Moth nurses take Jack from his room. He is injected yet again with a mysterious liquid as he screams. This time it makes him fall asleep. Hours later, Jack wakes up in a dark room locked up. He screams for help, but no one comes. Then, he's stunned to see Drake. Jack, baffled, asks Drake how he is in the room if he is dead. Drake confirms that he is indeed dead, but that he's also there. Jack, confused, asks if his friends are okay. Drake tells him that only temporarily. Drake explains to Jack that he's there to guide him, but it is Jack himself who must figure out what to do. Before leaving, Drake tells Jack that he has to make himself found. Jack begins feeling dizzy and falls to the floor. When he regains consciousness some time later, Drake is gone. Considering what he just heard, Jack begins to search the room and discovers a flare gun behind one of the walls. Cliffhanger. Johnson is worried after he fails to contact Robert, who's dead, but Dr. Reed reassures him, confirming that the surgery will begin in exactly 24 hours. Flashback plot. Set 1 year into the past, Jack is looking at a photo of his parents, Bill and Gabriella, missing them. He makes a promise to himself to always keep his little sister, Isla, safe. At the same time, he's very grateful of Nick for taking care of him after his parents died. Jack writes him a letter in case he ever dies. Episode 12, Flare, is centered around Elena. Main plot: Nick and Kenny continue traveling on their own. Nick asks Kenny again why he's willing to help him and betray the Moths. Kenny reaffirms that the Moths made him do horrible things that will eternally haunt him. He confirms he remains loyal to the group of protagonists. Later, they see a flare light up the sky. They now know where to go. Meanwhile, Danny and Peter stumble upon the girls and are reunited. Back in Lake Rocks, Johnson and his bodyguards pay a visit to Elena. Jerry worries. Johnson is aware that Elena refuged and helped Nick's group. He's not happy and claims there will be trouble. Liz and Chloe hide Isla so that she cannot be taken away, but fortunately the Moths leave. Cliffhanger. At the dead of night, Nick is startled after seeing Jack's ghost in the distance. Jack's ghost doesn't say a word, but signals for Nick to follow him. Nick runs towards him. Kenny is confused. Flashback plot. Set 3 months into the past, Elena is visited by Robert and the Moths. They're there to take some of the goods that Lake Rocks has. Elena is obviously outraged. Robert tries manipulating her into thinking they're doing it for a greater reason, but she doesn't believe them. Jerry tries calming her down. Episode 13, Hope, is centered around Lily. Main plot. Nick runs toward the ghost of Jack, desperate to get to him. Eventually, he sees himself at the edge of a small hill. Below him is a gargantuan horde of the Unalife. Jack's ghost is nowhere to be seen anymore. Soon, Kenny catches up to him and both stare at the Unalife. Kenny freaks out at Nick for running off. In the morning, Nick explains to Kenny how he saw Jack's ghost guiding him. The two continue walking. Meanwhile, Peter, Lydia, Lily, and Co. are getting closer to Nick. Jack is abruptly woken up and dragged by the Moths. As he screams, he's placed on a surgery table. Dr. Reed and Joson enter the room. The nurse confirms everything is ready for the surgery to start. Cliffhanger. Johnson gives the order and the surgery on Jack is starting. Jack screams and tries to resist. Flash forward plot. Set 2 years into the future, Lily becomes the hero after one of the members of Lake Rocks falls sick and she helps them get better. With help from Haley, Lily is able to make the person who fell sick get healthy again. Episode 14, One Last Time, Part 1, is centered around Dr. Reed. Main plot. Nick and Kenny arrive at the U.S. government Moth building where Jack is being held. Peter, Lydia, Lily, and the rest of the protagonists are right behind them, and the group is once again reunited. The building is heavily protected, and they strategize a way to break in and take Jack back. Kenny suggests sneaking through the back to set off the loud emergency alarm system. This will attract the gargantuan horde of Unalife they saw a few miles back and create a distraction. The protagonists agree and Kenny goes ahead. Not long after the alarm is set off, the soldiers militarizing the zone are stunned to see the Unalife approach them rapidly. Nick, Lydia, and Peter take the opportunity to sneak into the building whilst the Moths are distracted. Meanwhile, Johnson has to leave the surgery room after the alarm goes off and orders Dr. Reed and the nurses to take Jack to the secret room to proceed with the surgery. Johnson goes into his office and tells Francis to join Dr. Reed. Johnson is shocked to see the horde of Unaliv through the window. Nick, Peter, and Lydia make their way through the building unnoticed since the moths are too busy dealing with the attack from the Unalife. Eventually, they break into Johnson's office. Johnson tries calling for help, but they shoot his phone. Nick demands to know in what floor and room Jack is being held. Johnson resists, but after Lydia cuts off his finger, Johnson reveals Jack's location. Johnson tells Nick that he won't get away with it. Nick smiles at Johnson before shooting him in the head. Cliffhanger. Peter suggests that it would have been a better idea to take him with them in case he lied, but Nick reassures him, claiming, "I believed him." Flashback plot. Set 2 years into the past, Dr. Reed and another doctor are performing a surgery on a patient who's been bitten, using all of their knowledge to try to save him. In the end, the surgery is not successful and the man turns into the Unalife. Dr. Reed is desperate, claiming that finding a cure or even stopping someone who's been bitten from turning is impossible. Later, his wife comforts him. Episode 15, One Last Time, Part 2, is centered around Dr. Reed. Flashback plot. Set 1 year into the past, Dr. Reed makes a great discovery. He finds out that if they can find somebody who is immune to the virus, they can copy the cells that reject it and develop a vaccine. Ironically, only days later, Francis comes back with a file that confirms Jack is immune to the virus. Dr. Reed is euphoric, believing that they have found their patient zero, with whom they can begin to develop the vaccine with. Main plot. Whilst the moths are struggling to keep the Unalife away, with many soldiers having died at this point, the rest of the protagonists, Danny and co., have found a van and are filling it with fuel to run away when Nick comes back with Jack. Nick, Lydia, and Peter shoot everybody they find inside the building, making their way to find Jack. They hop into the elevator and head towards the top floor. However, the elevator gets stuck and Nick, Peter, and Lydia are forced to find an alternative way out. Meanwhile, the Unalife have begun to enter the building. Lydia is able to squeeze through the ceiling of the elevator and later helps Peter and Nick get through as well. Forced to make their way up the stairs, they start to get shot at by the moths, but manage to pull through and kill all of them. Nick, Peter, and Lydia finally make it to the final room in the hallway where Jack is. They kick open the door and are shocked to see Jack unconscious on the surgery table. Francis, standing beside Dr. Reed, reaches for his gun, but Peter shoots him in the neck with a rifle. Dr. Reed, holding a syringe containing a mysterious liquid to Jack's neck, as a form of leverage, tells Nick that he is making a mistake. Nick refuses to listen. Dr. Reed tells Nick that this moment is bigger than anything they have ever or will ever be involved in. Nick gives Dr. Reed the opportunity to walk away alive and unharmed. However, Dr. Reed insists and claims that he can restore the normal world they once lived in. Nick says he doesn't want to return to that world and that a vaccine is meaningless to him. Dr. Reed, disappointed, tells Nick that this is a historic moment in human history and claims Nick won't stop him. Suddenly, he quickly stretches his arm to stab Jack with the syringe. However, Nick shoots Dr. Reed in the head, stopping him and saving Jack's life. Nick, Peter, and Lydia carry the unconscious Jack out of the room, past the Unalife and remaining moths, out of the building, and put him in the van the rest of the protagonists found. They hit the gas and get away. They did it. Three years later, Jack strolls through Lake Rocks, smiling at everybody. He stops at Nick's grave and thanks him for everything. Sky approaches him and the two talk. Jack is feeling melancholic. Sky reassures him, claiming Nick would be proud of him. Jack smiles. Later, the members of Lake Rocks enjoy a nice meal together in harmony. Final scene. In a strange final twist, we zoom in on Jack's eye before we see the entire show rewind back to the very beginning. We see Olivia wake up from what seems like a nightmare in great distress, before the door to her room squeals as it slowly opens. Then everything goes black. Ladies and gentlemen, that is officially the end of Unolife. I really hope you have enjoyed this set of videos. It has taken me many hours to complete the guides for all 8 seasons, but I really enjoyed the process. And who knows, maybe this turns into a real thing on Netflix one day, and you can say you saw it first on this channel. Did you like it? Who was your favorite character? What interests you the most? What did you interpret from the final scene? Please let me know any doubts you may have. Thank you for watching and joining me. I will see you on the next one. Peace.